Hi everyone, Chef from Outdoors in the Low Countries. Now in this video we're going to unbox, install and review this table saw, the Itamac Pantera S9. This table saw has a 400 volt connection and the engine power is 5.5 horsepower. And the working table is 1120 mm wide, 686 mm deep. And the wooden elevation table that comes along with it is 812 mm wide. And the saw is delivered with this fence that can be used at the left and at the right side of your saw blade. And it can be locked with this handle. And there's a magnet in the handle of the fence, and as a result, it will always stay up. And when moving, it will not touch the sidebar. And the bearing of this fence is at the front side done with these adjustable Teflon gliders, and also an adjustable Teflon glider at the back side. And this fence really runs smooth over the table saw. And with this wooden side table, the maximum working distance at the right side of the saw is 132 centimeters or 52 inch. And with the rib fence all the way to the right, the maximum working distance between fence and saw blade is 126 centimeters or 50 inch. The miter gauge has a range of plus to minus 60 degrees and has three quick settings: 0 degrees, plus 45, minus 45 degrees. And the quick settings can be fine adjusted at the correct angle. And it also has an adjustable end stop, which can be put in and taken out. This cover plate is held in place by four magnets and can thereby be easily taken out, do whatever you want, and put back, and it is adjusted by these four screws. Raising and lowering of the saw blade is being done by this heavy duty cast iron wheel. And you can fixate it by turning this knob. And the same type of wheel is used at the left side to put the saw blade under an angle towards the left with a maximum of 45 degrees. And also here, it is fixated by turning this knob at the front side of the wheel. And the saw originally comes with this safety cover for the saw blade. It can also be delivered with this removable dust cover, which has a hose connection of 100 mm, so it really has serious exhaust power at your saw blade. And this dust extraction can be set at different levels of height depending on the type of work and fixated. And in the package, also a cover is included with a wider slit to facilitate dado saw blades. The system is being delivered with a saw blade of 40 teeth, and in the total package of saw and dust extraction system, also an Italian made 60 teeth saw blade is included from Klein, as well as this feather pressure system from Bow. Now when I went into the shop to buy a new table saw, I went in to buy a Harvey Black Edition. But in the end, I decided to buy this one, the Itamac Pantera S9. And there were three reasons for that. The main reason is that this saw is being delivered with this dust extraction system with a huge discount. And I really prefer this dust extraction. And the second reason is that I really like to have the magnet closure of this cover. I've seen some reviews on YouTube where people really complaining about this device getting loose. This will never happen with this magnet closure. And the third reason is that this system comes with this industrial Teflon fence with the adjustable bearing system. So I decided to buy this system instead of the Harvey. And there are two 100 mm dust extraction exhaust connections, one at the backside, the bottom of the saw, and one at the side of the table for the dust extraction hood at the top side. And in the package I also included this transport system from Tendo Tools, so it's that easy to relocate the table saw when required.
and the engine has an industrial dovetail mounting.
The engine is switched on by first disabling the turn off knob, like this, and then pushing the green button. So let's also do the famous vibration test.
So the system has passed the vibration test.
Now for changing the dividing knife position, you first take off the cover. Now the dividing knife can be set at two positions. This is the low position. And by releasing the system, you can just then put it at the high position, fixate it again, and easily also put it back at the low position. And put the cover back with the magnetic closure. That's it.
And with the reading pane, the exact position of the fans is easy to read out on the ruler.
So we now looked at the features of this saw. Now let's also see how the system is being shipped, unboxed and installed.
So this is how the system is being delivered on the pallet in a wooden crate together with some other boxes and also some other boxes which are not here yet, lying somewhere else. So let's unpack it and install the system. So the system is well packed, well protected, oil paper on the table, transparent stickers on the labels, and also it is bolted towards this bottom part. So the first step is to take out the bolt so it can be taken out of this wooden plate.
So there's a bolt on the bottom side and it does seem that they are rotating when you try to turn it loose. So I will remove this cover, see if I can see the nuts on the other side.
There's a 16mm nut that you need to loose in order to loosen the saw from the crate.
So we also ordered a mobile station so you can easily move it around. Let's see if I can put it directly onto this mobile base. So let's open the box. There is small inequality in the trolley. I hope you can see it in the video like this. So this one has an angle like this. This one has a straight angle. This one is by far not straight.
This transport carries from Tendo Tools and you can clearly see the poor job that the welder has done. This one is quite straight, this one is pointing down. As a result, you have a very wobbly construction. And this is of course something you don't want. So these are the fixed wheels, the other side are the rotating wheels. So if you want to correct for it, it's best to use the fixed wheel because the distance from the wheel towards the frame will always be the same. And when I now put this underneath, then the wobbling is gone. So the next step is to put this underneath the wheel to prevent wobbling it around.
So I created this interface plate to correct for the poor welding of the transport tool. But now my bolts are too short, so I also have to take longer bolts because of course I have the interface plate now in between, which takes some extra thickness. And the wobble is gone. So by default, the side tables are hanging down, so you have to move them up a little bit.
And now we look from underneath the side table and we see that the level adjustment is possible by these three hexagon bolts.
And in this way you can adjust the tables so they are level as well as straight, using in this case a bubble level. So this long box also came with the package. I'm not sure what's inside. Let's open it up and we'll find out. I just mounted this table legs to this wooden side table, and in order to adjust the length of the legs to the floor, this has to be fixated well onto the thread. Now in this case this is loose, so what I try to do is fixate it with a nut to make sure that it's not loose again. But what happens is that the nut is already gone, so this is already broken. That's not a good thing from Itamak to put in a broken leg. So what I will do now is I will take this hole out, see if I have another nut that I can put in place, and maybe then I can fixate it. Let's see. So you can't really move the nut around without moving it. So let's see how bad it is. So now it's properly fixated and you can really adjust the table leg. So we have a glue clamp, I've now leveled out the wooden side table. With the leg adjustment, I can make sure it's completely level with the sidebar. So everything is now adjusted well using this long glider, the glue clamps and the adjustable table leg. So everything is now properly aligned. Next step is now to drill in holes in this wooden side table in order to fix it. Now I made the mistake of putting the table leg to this side of the side table. And that cannot be because there's a hole here where you need to fixate it towards this beam, and then this table leg is in the way. So what I now need to do is to place the table leg at the back side of there, so that the bolt can still be fixated. So if you're ever going to put the side table together, don't make the mistake that I did. Put it at the back right away.
Due to unflatness of the cast iron tables, there's still a ridge present at some places, so we used a rubber hammer to minimize this ridge before final fixation of the tables.
The bolts of the electrical switch are very critical and they more or less stick through. They even had to replace this one because it was also from a bad quality. So now they're sticking through just a little bit. In order to prevent misalignment from the ruler just being a little bit too high, I will drill in a hole in the ruler so that the bolt can stick through. And then we use an 8mm drill to do that. And here you see the two markings, here and here, which I made from underneath. And some paint to prevent corrosion. Now this is the original cover that comes with this saw. but I'm not going to use this one. Instead, I will use the Orca S17 dust collector, which has a connection for a 100 mm hose to have proper dust extraction. Now, looking at this cover, you can see that the connection with the bar is exactly at the middle of the saw. And also, when you make it higher or lower, it will stay that way. So that means that I have to have a connection at this point here, at the middle of the saw. And the middle of the blade is exactly 30 cm from the backside edge. So I will now put this pencil at exactly 30 cm. So this is now lying at the center of the blade. But this piece will be mounted at the side of the table, and this is the location where the bar will go. So I want to have this at this location. Now this will be about here, the edge of the table at the front. Typical thing is that this is now too short. So the leg is about 1 cm too short because the saw is now on wheels. Let's for now do it like this. Then at least I have some support. Now the next step is to place this side bracket to the side of the table. And of course with the holes you have to prevent that you're drilling straight through your table leg. So you have to fixate a little bit, like I now did. So I cannot drill a hole without going to the table legs. On the back side, I will drill into the mounting plate of the legs. That's fine, that's no problem. It only makes sure that you will have your table legs stronger attached to the system. So there's no problem there. So let's mark our drill holes. Now because there's metal plate on the backside, I will continue with a metal drill. Now for mounting this diagonal brace, the manual says to use a wood screw or a bolt to mount it on the underside of the table. But this table is relatively thin, so if you use a wood screw, it will come through. That's not what you want, of course. So what I will do is I will drill a hole here in this side of this beam going through the other side of the table, and then I will mount it at the back side, and it will do the same on the other side of the table. And then with a screw with a sunken head, I can then mount it onto the table without sticking out. Now I modified this bracket to have a larger angle so it can fit underneath. So now the dust extraction is mounted. Leveling can be done by the diagonal braces adjustment. You can make it higher or lower, whatever you prefer. What is really nice is by loosening a locking pin, you can simply swing it away. So now you're able to do high work, and as soon as you're ready with your high work, you can swing it back and lock it again. Now the nice thing about it is this has an angle and there's no edge here. So the dust, the wood dust will always come here and then go into the manifold of the exhaust. There's no ridge or anything that will prevent it from coming in. Now let's also put the fan system on. So this is the zero position, and I'm now going to create a mark here, which I can use as the zero mark for my ruler. This is the mounting gauge that comes along with the device. Let's put it in. So also the mounting gauge is perfect square. So now I will adjust it so it will be at this position every time. So let's redo the check. Perfect. And as you can see, the alignment is possible for 0 degrees and plus and minus 45 degrees as well. With this way, we can create a perfect 90 degrees of the saw. So also the exhaust system is now connected. It's time to also connect the power onto this device, and let's do a test run. So the 400 volt connection. So if you now press the green start button, nothing will change. Is there something wrong? No, because the stop button is still engaged. Now to disable this, you have to turn to the right. It pops forward. Now it's disabled. If you now press start, system will run. So the fence is set at 20 millimeters, and when I measure it up, I also get exactly 20 millimeters. So it's perfectly adjusted. So the exhaust system works very nice. With the handle, you can easily adjust it. What you also see, of course, is that when you have to put your fence in between, because you are very close to the knife, that the exhaust system goes up a little, and as a result, you get a little bit more dust onto your saw. But yeah, that's understandable. So the saw did pass the first test, so I think it's now time to remove all this cover plastics, so to make it a real beauty. So I really like the robustness and high quality build of this table saw, as well as the well performing dust extraction. So I'm sure many projects will be performed on this piece of equipment. So we hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.